Hello everyone, this video is for class 10th. Subject is information technology and the subject code is 402. So here is a content of the subject. It consists of 7 units. First one is functional English, second one is web applications, third one is word processing, that is MS Word, fourth one is spreadsheet, that is MS Excel, fifth one is digital presentation, that is MS PowerPoint. Sixth one is email messaging, and seventh one is database development, that is MS Access. So we will start with the second unit, that is web applications. Unit 2, web application. It consists of 8 sessions. Session 1, working with accessibility's option. Section 2, networking concepts. Session 3, introduction to instant messaging. Session 4, chatting with a contact. Session 5, creating and publishing web pages, that is blogs. Session 6, using offline blog editors. Session 7, online transaction. And session 8, internet security. So we will start with session 1, that is working with accessibility options. First of all, we'll discuss what is accessibility's options. So, computer accessibility refers to a user friendliness of a computer system for all, regardless of their disability. This is mainly a software issue. However, when a combination of hardware and software, it enables a person with a disability or impairment to use a computer. It is known as assistive technology. It enables a person with a disability or impairment to use a computer. There are numerous types of impairment that impact computer usage. These include cognitive impairments and learning disabilities like dyslexia, autism, and so on. Some visual impairments such as low vision or complete vision or partial vision, or you can say complete or partial blindness and color blindness. Hearing impairments including deafness, motor impairments such as paralysis. Now the next topic is how to launch accessibility option. To launch accessibility option, we have to click start, then control panel, then click the option accessibility option. The accessibility options window will appear. It will display 5 tabs. The very first tab is keyboard tab. The first option in the keyboard tab is sticky keys. Sticky keys is an accessibility feature to help computer users with physical disabilities, but it is also used by others as a means to reduce repetitive strain. Sticky keys allows the user to press and release a modifier key such as Shift, Control, Alt or the Windows key and have it remain active until any other key is pressed. This feature is very helpful for those people whose one hand is not working properly. To enable sticky keys, select Use Sticky Keys option, click on Apply, then click on OK. Now the next option in keyboard tab is filter keys. Filter keys is a feature of Microsoft Windows. It is an accessibility function that tells the keyboard to ignore brief or repetitive keystrokes. It makes typing easier for people with hand tremors. To enable filter keys, check Use filter keys. Then click Settings under Filter Keys and check Ignore Repeated Keystrokes. Then click on Apply and click OK. Now the next option in keyboard tabs is Toggle Keys. Toggle Keys is also a feature of Microsoft Windows. It is an accessibility function which is designed for people who have vision impairment or cognitive disabilities. When the toggle keys is turned on, computer emits sound cues when the locking keys like caps lock, num lock or scroll lock are pressed. A high sound is emitted when the keys are switched on and a low sound is emitted when they are switched off. To enable toggle keys, check use toggle keys, click settings under toggle keys, then click on apply and then click OK. That's all for this video. In the next video, I'll discuss rest of the tabs of accessibility options.